I would like to speak on behalf of my band Necrophilia, also on behalf of my family, the Sanchez Moran family, and on behalf of my left organization, the Internationalist Group. Our cousin Osvaldo Sevilla Moran died tragically on Saturday, August 1st, half a block from the building he lived in, up in the Bronx. Obi was only 31 years old. He left two sons of ages 17 and 7 years old, plus a grandson who is 2 years old now. But Obi did not die of natural causes. He was killed by the racist NYPD. The full details we still don't know, and perhaps we will never know them. One thing we do know is how the police act when they see a black person or a Latino in the streets of the ghettos. The hands of the police are stained with blood of hundreds of lives of young people from the working class. The list is long. Sean Bell, who was killed under a rain of lead of 50 shots the day of his wedding in Queens. Patrick Dorismond, killed in Manhattan in 2000 by another cover narcotics detective. Anthony Baez, choked to death in 1995 by Officer Livari, right in front of his house in the Bronx. 10-year-old Clifford Glover, killed execution style in 1973. Randolph Evans, 15 years old. Eleanor Bumpers, an old woman, an old black woman, killed by the police while they were trying to evict her from her apartment in 1984. Malcolm Ferguson, killed in 2000, a few blocks away from where Amadou Diallo was riddled with 41 bullets in 1999. Alberta Sproul, Nicholas Hayward, you get the point. And now our dead, dear cousin Obi joins this infamous list. Obi used to go to see us play often. The last time he went to see us play, the bouncers wouldn't let him in and his friends because he didn't have an ID. So in solidarity with the people turned away for not having ID, the bar told the organizer of the event that if Obi and his friends weren't allowed, our band wouldn't play. Finally, the bouncers gave in and we went on with the show. That night, Obi recorded 2 or 3 songs and he later on uploaded the videos on YouTube. In this particular occasion, we were commemorating the 40th anniversary of the October 2nd Tlatelolco massacre in Mexico. How ironic that the last show Obi went to and recorded was dedicated to martyrs of the Tlatelolco massacre, where hundreds of workers, professors, and student strikers were killed by the Mexican army and a special police outfit, the infamous elite group, Grupo Olimpia. One thing I must state clearly, I knew Obi since he was a little kid. I am 4 years older than him, and he, ever since I've known him, he wasn't a violent person. He didn't go around looking for trouble. The times I hung out with Obi, he was always quiet. He wouldn't say anything unless you asked him to. He wouldn't start a conversation unless you started. Obi and I got drunk a few times, but he never lost his cool and calm. At least the times we went out drinking, he never got aggravated. Furthermore, he didn't even curse when he was with me. A very unpleasant incident had to occur for Obi to go out into the streets armed that tragic Saturday morning. I like to quote a message a friend from school sent me when she read the New York Times article on Obi's assassination. I am really sorry to hear that your cousin died yesterday. I saw his blood on the floor. He was next to a box in the corner by the light pole. Rumor has it that he bought the gun to protect himself from being robbed again. A friend of mine was awakened by the 49 shots that were fired. She said that she didn't dare stick her head out the window to see what had happened until the gunfire stopped. She said that people must have been hiding under the parked cars on the streets because people like to hang out late on the weekends on that part of the Bronx. To wrap things up, independently of the motives, Obi had to go out armed with a gun. He didn't shoot to kill. The NYPD did. We must understand one thing. The police is not here in this society to protect us, the poor, the black, the Latinos, documented or undocumented immigrants, the working class. No, the main task of the police is to protect the private property of bosses, the capitalist class, those parasites who suck the blood out of the working class. The work of the police is to repress the toiling masses. They are the iron fist of the ruling class. The police, whether white, black, or Latino, is racist through and through. They are not our friends, and they are not part of the working class. They are paid mercenaries, professional oppressors. They are the guardian dogs of the bosses. Family, relatives and friends of Bobby, we all feel demoralized, impotent, tied hands and feet because we weren't able to do anything against this injustice. Because independently of his actions that terrible morning, Bobby did not deserve to die this way. We cannot let his death be in vain. We must fight against this system that suffocates us from day to day with this racist police. The most important lesson to be drawn from this horrible homicide is the necessity of the class struggle, revolutionary and international in character, against the capitalist class. This also means a fight against the bourgeois politicians, Democrat and Republican alike, and the police, because the police is their armed fist, the bosses have all in their favor. Their courts, the judges, their prisons, the army, and their death penalty. The police is the backbone of this machine of coercion that is the state. Yes, the bourgeoisie has almost all in its favor, but we have the masses, and the working masses have the power to bring this society to a screeching halt.
Yeah!
Because without the working class, this society cannot run. There is where our power lies. To put an end to this system of police violence, we have to sweep away the ruling class. There will be no justice for Obi or the countless victims of the racist police terror, including Malcolm Ferguson, until this capitalist system that engenders racism and war is torn asunder through workers' revolution. Only the proletariat will avenge all the innocent blood spilled by the murderous police, our dear beloved departed Obi included, because an injury to one is an injury to all.